You are about to find out if Champions Online is worth playing in 2021, so stick till the end of the video and you will know for sure if this is for you or not. We will discuss the game by categories and the first one is the gameplay mechanics. Champions Online combat is top targeted with some special attacks from enemies that you have to be aware of and block them. It felt smooth and really optimized. I prefer normally action-oriented combat, but I have nothing against top targeted as long as it provides something to block or dodge, like some attacks that will do a lot of damage to you if you stand in them. This feature makes the gameplay more immersive because you can't really just press buttons and that's it. You have to dodge or block or stun the mob when it's about to do his move or you would be in danger. This game gives you the ability to stay in guard position by pressing the shift button. Abilities in this game consumes energy, but you can restore it by using the basic attack or by being attacked while you are in guard. I picked a tank class and it was really easy for me because I would lure all the monsters in a particular room, then use my AoE ability, and after I used all my energy I was staying in guard again until it replenished and then repeat. The skills animation are nothing too impressive, but they are in the theme of a superhero game. For my Behemoth class, there was nothing crazy, just some punches, a leap, or a shockwave created by clapping my hands. You have your typical abilities that you press and they will trigger, or some that you can charge them and make them more powerful in terms of damage, or charge them until half or not at all for faster activation. As long as the movement in this game, you will be able to pick at level 6 your traveling superpower, and the list is very large, like all the other things this game has to offer. You can fly, jump really high, use super speed, be acrobatic and jump faster and higher than any normal human, teleporting, sliding, jetpacks, transform into a huge snowball, into a blob of ink or water, and the list goes on. The game really gives you plenty of options, and if like that isn't enough, you can buy effects too for your traveling superpowers. What is upsetting is that they are restricted, and if you want to have them, as long as all the movement abilities, you'll have to take out your wallet and do some donations. And from what I saw, a lot of things in this game are only obtainable with real money or a gold subscription that is $20. Well, in the end, at least the game really feels like a superhero game, and besides DC Online, that I will cover in the future, we don't really have these kinds of games, and that is a shame because it is a cool setting and everyone wants to really be a superhero, especially from the Marvel movies being popular at the moment. Oh yeah, and the game lets you pick up cars, or boulders, or benches, or anything else from the environment and throw them into the enemies. The next thing I want to discuss is the character customization and classes. Well, in the beginning, you have to pick a class. I was really surprised when I saw how many of them are in the game. You have 4 main branches and they are Ranged DPS, Tank, Melee DPS and Support. Ranged had the most options, like 11, and the rest around 6 or 7. You can be almost any archetype you can imagine, Fire, Ice, Samurai, Mind Control, Healer, having gadgets, having a bow, guns, swords, even chains. You can be a big beast, a big stone man, martial artist and much more. The game has really big variety of classes to pick from and all of them are having different skills. Even if they repeat a little bit in some of the branches like Ice DPS or Ice Tank, as well as few others. What is cool about Champions Online is that you can go for a free form and it lets you create your own archetype. In this game, you will have to pick a base stat like Con, Strength, Dex that your character will be based on. After that, you will have to pick your second and third stat. Based on them, you can customize your role, and in free form you can pick whatever skills you want from all archetypes and create a unique character. This is really a great feature, especially in a superhero game where you have all kinds of powers. What is upsetting again is that you have to pay for a free form slot. So now that we clarify the classes, let's talk about the character customization. Here, the game is overwhelming. You have so many things you can choose from, like all kinds of wings, tails, clothes, head accessories, back accessories, accessories on every part of the body, and so much more. You can create all kinds of things too, from cool looking superheroes that are based on Batman, Superman, to really funny looking creatures, to scary ones, weird ones, I mean, you have everything. I won't really talk too much here, because it will take me an entire hour, so I will let you discover it and have fun with the system. I spent about 2 hours in the character creation because I couldn't decide how I want to make my character. After I finally did it, I played it to about level 7 and because I made a DPS class I felt a little too squishy, so I deleted it and made another character in the tank spec. Here, I stayed again for 2 hours to think how I wanted to make. I was changing things all the time and looking how it will be if I did this or that or what other color would be fit on the pants or on the hand and things like that. I was really in doubt every time on how my character will look the best, but I had a great time making it. It's okay at least that you can customize your character how much you want at NPCs, and you can even create multiple customs for it if you buy more slots. So the game classes are really great and you have plenty to pick from. And the character customization is one of the greatest I have seen in terms of things you can put on your character and how you want it to look. Let's talk about the story. Here, we have some main story that our hero follows. First, the game starts with a simulated tutorial where you fight some aliens. At level 6 though, you are going to the Millennium City, the main city of the game. Here, your journey is to fight the gangs of the streets and beat their leaders, and at the end of this chapter, you fight a mage that tried to rule them all by summoning a dragon that was under his control. The story is presented with cutscenes in most of the quests and it has good voice acting. It's cool that even smaller quests got cutscenes when the villain is presented or when it is showing to you what is happening there. I was not expecting that and I felt really immersed in the story. After completing the first act at around level 15, I was presented two options. Either go to solve the Canada Crisis, a snowy region, or the Desert Crisis, a desert-like zone like the name suggests. I picked Canada and here was something different in terms of the story, because I was not fighting gangs but some kind of mage that summons a death god or other evil spirits. I can't wait to find what is happening farther down the road and to beat all the evildoers. I did not expect for the game to have a story and one voice acted and with so many cutscenes even for small quests. Great job, Champions Online! Like I said before, a lot of the quests are having cutscenes and are really diversified. You will fight in the open map of each region, but you will be sent in some small instant zones. For example, in the main city I was sent to fight maniacs in the sewers. In one quest I had to fight a villain that stole the main television program and was broadcasting his fights, but I got rid of him really quick. In the Canada region I was sent to caves, occult domains and under frozen lakes where I fought piranhas. One well implemented feature is that you have some tutorial missions that actually learns you how to do stuff like upgrading, crafting and things like that with cutscenes and pictures, even explanatory videos for some. As long as we are still here, let's talk about the questing too. The game has really different kind of quests and I was having a lot of fun. I'm really glad that you don't do only kill X amount of things or collecting ones. I had missions where I had to dig after survivors in the snowy regions, to pick buildings up from civilian, to extinguish fire, to dress as some of the enemy to be able to infiltrate them, and much more. I fought a lot of different enemies and bosses, escorted NPCs, destroyed evil plans and had a lot of fun doing all of that. Champions Online is really immersive and fun as a leveling experience, one that I was not ready for and I received it with open arms. I really felt like a superhero doing all the stuff that I told you about. Let's talk about the gear. This department won't have so many things to talk about, because you decide what your character will look like and the gear is just for stats. It has no cosmetic value. One thing though that I want to talk about is that you have some gadgets you can equip, like consumables in something like Batman's belt. You can have grenades, blasters, grappling hooks. You can even call some reinforcements from some of the gangs or other type of enemies to help you for 30 seconds. These trinkets should exist in more games because they add an extra layer of customization for your gameplay overall. What about the atmosphere of the game? Well, in this spectrum, I can tell you that it is really a true superhero game and every aspect of it feels like one. From the classes, to the character customization, the things you do, the environments, I mean everything. You have your villain everywhere in the world, their henchmen, a lot of mutated things, a lot of evil devices you have to destroy, and the best part, a lot of other players you can see doing their jobs or just hanging around in the Millennium City. The game really felt alive and I was just looking at how cool some of the players really looked. You have so many other customs and effects that you can buy with real money, or I think you can farm that currency in game too from what I read on the forums, and this gives you a lot of new things to do. What was really delightful was that some of the civilian NPCs will come to you to thank you for fighting bad guys, and some even told me that they saw me on the internet and I was becoming a popular superhero. It is really a great idea from the devs and I'm glad that they implemented it. Let's talk about the cash shop and how pay to win is. From what I understand, the game is only paid to progress faster and not giving any real advantage to players, only in the slot of the freeform character that you can access OP skills, but that is only if you are a PvP focused player. Other things though is that you can trade in games currencies for Zen, the real money currency, and that makes things a little bit fair and balanced, so you will be able to buy your cosmetics or other things you want from the game. Endgame. Well, in the endgame you can either grind for items and trade currencies to participate in the fashion war or do PvP arenas. Anyway, if you are here for the PvE content, you will have a blast until endgame, maybe even then. Okay, before we will talk about pros and cons, support me into making more videos about games to know if you should play them or not by feeding the algorithm beast with a like. Also, If you like the content, join the legacy by using the subscribe spell. If you think I missed something or have other opinion about the game, feel free to leave a comment, I would appreciate the feedback. And don't forget, I try games, so you don't have to waste your time. Pros and cons. What I liked about the game is that it's really immersive and I felt like a superhero in an universe of the same team, fighting villains and saving people. The character customization is one of the best that I saw, one where you can create almost everything and the classes are plenty, so you will have what to choose from. The combat felt optimized and felt really good too. The quests are really different and mostly voice acted. In terms of what I disliked about the game, I can't really find anything major to say, maybe if there were a little bit more population, and the fact that I regret that I didn't play this kind of MMORPG gems back in the day, and it would be great if they would make a Champions Online 2 or a remaster. I mean, this thing should be happening with most MMORPGs that are out there and are outdated. So, would I recommend this game to my viewers? Yes, absolutely. It is anything that you would expect from a superhero game, and I want you to download it right now. I had a really unexpected fun with the game, and I regret that I don't have time right now to play more of it because I have to put up more videos for the channel, but in the future I will want to revisit it and play on a freeform archetype to see what I can do. Maybe I will stream most of my gameplays, but until then, trust me on this one. You will have a blast. Go download Champions Online right now. Irene approves. Okay, so that will wrap things up for today's video. Thank you for watching and may the gods of good luck be with you in your grindy days. See you soon!